So MDS, or myelodysplastic syndrome, sometimes referred to as pre-leukemia, is a kind of cancer of bone marrow involving the cells then that make our blood. Those cells are stem cells, and they have been transformed to a kind of cancer, which is, however, typically slow-growing or, in doctor's words, indolent. MDS is an uncommon problem, but becomes more frequent in people as they age. But for younger individuals, MDS is a serious and life-changing and often life-threatening problem. For the great majority of patients, we don't know the causes of MDS. Certainly, people who have been exposed to prior chemotherapy or radiation therapy are at increased risk. Certain chemicals, benzene is the best established one, are well recognized to be associated with MDS. The class of drugs we call alkylating agents, often used for treating breast cancer, multiple myeloma, but also lung cancers and various kinds of gastrointestinal malignancies are associated with the development of MDS. The symptoms of MDS are usually weakness or bleeding or bruising, but there are many other conditions that can cause those symptoms after all. And so usually MDS is diagnosed after a physician requests blood work from a patient and blood counts, white blood count, red cell counts, or platelet counts are found to be abnormally low. The first thing to say for MDS is that in most patients, the initial problem is low blood counts. Very often, for example, low red cell counts. And so supportive care with transfusions is very important. And many, many MDS patients need transfusions over some years. Transfusions can be of red cells or platelets, depending on the need of the particular patient. There are certain medications which are effective for MDS, or at least for some patients with MDS. So there are two intravenous or injectable chemotherapies which are available and which can produce sometimes complete remissions of MDS, and in other cases significant benefit over time. And for a selected and small group of MDS patients, there's an oral medication that can be active and very effective. There's a great deal of research going on into both the cause of MDS and its treatment. Certainly it's an important thing to try to prevent, but for most cases we see, there's no clear cause.